Hey friends, welcome to Knack Graphics. In this video, we are going to draw this design. This abstract design is drawn by playing with some very simple shapes and some visual effects. So let's see how to draw it. We will start with creating a new document. I'm going with the web large document. First of all, make sure that Smartguides option is on. Now pick the rectangle tool and draw an artboard size rectangle and keep the stroke size to 0. Now for the fill color, go to the colors panel and open HSP options. Here enter 240 for hue, 100 for saturation and 40 for the brightness. Now go to the layers panel and lock this rectangle. Now zoom out a bit, pick line segment tool and set the stroke size to 500. Now draw a straight line from the center of this rectangle up to approximately at this point. Keep this line selected, change its width profile from this section to width profile 4. Now we have to reverse the stroke profile. For this, go to the stroke panel and press this button to flip along the stroke profile. Now we will convert this stroke to outline. For this, go to the object menu, path and click outline stroke. Now we need to change the color of the shape. For this, go to the colors panel and open HSP options. Now dial in 350 for hue, 100 for saturation and 95 for the brightness. Keep this shape selected, pick the rotate tool, come over this anchor point, press Alt key and click once to open the rotate dialog box. Here enter 30 degrees and click copy. Now press Ctrl D to repeat this action and create total 12 copies. Go to the layers panel now and lock all these created paths along with the rectangle which is already locked. Pick rectangle tool again, set the fill and stroke to none. Now again draw an artboard sized rectangle. Now go to the layers panel once again, unlock all the shapes and press this button to select all the content of this layer. Now go to the Pathfinder panel and run divide operation. If you don't have this panel here, you can find it here in window menu. Now after running the divide operation, you can see that a group has been formed. We don't need that group. So go to object menu and select ungroup. Divide function has divided the whole shape into small individual shapes. Now we will delete the unnecessary shapes. For this, grab the black arrow tool and select all these shapes and delete them like this. Press Ctrl 0 to fit the artboard to screen size. Now select all these shapes by pressing Ctrl A and make a group of it by pressing Ctrl G. Now press Ctrl C to copy and paste it in front by pressing Ctrl F. Now the copy in front is selected, go to the transform panel, make sure that this constraint button is on. Now deduct 500 from its width. With this shape selected, go to the effects menu, stylize and pick inner glow. Here set the mode to multiply and for the color of glow, dial 102 for all R, G and B values. Set the opacity to 75% and blur to 70. Now copy this rectangle and press Ctrl F to paste its copy in front. Now with this copy selected, go to the transform panel and again deduct 500 from its width. Now again copy this rectangle and paste its copy in front and for the last time reduce its width by 500. Now select this rectangle, double click this rotate button to open rotate dialog box and enter 1 degree here. Now select this rectangle and double click this rotate button again to open rotate dialog box and this time enter minus 1 degree here. And finally, select this rectangle and rotate it by 1 degree. Basic design is ready now, and for the final move, we will add an effect for this artwork. For this, go to the layers panel and meatball this layer. Now go to the effect menu, here texture, and go for the grain effect. Here, set the intensity to 40, contrast to 50, and set the grain type to soft. So, the design is ready now. Hit like and share if you like this tutorial. Thanks for watching Knack Graphics.